Good evening. Welcome to Rocky Remembered. In the words of the man himself, remember who you are, what you are, and who you represent. The Arsenal.
Since we lost Dave, fantastic lad. He had a great family. I think his family still come to the games. What a player. You know, I always remember him just being a very, very young kid, enthusiastic, loved to tackle. I think the one thing I remember about Dave, especially on the football pitch, was if anyone was giving us grief, i.e. tackling a little bit rough, rougher than they should have, Dave Rodecastle would sort them out. He was almost like a little Captain Marvel. A little bit like Brian Robson in respect, and fantastic lad, fantastic player. I see the clips today, you know, I watched the game against Blackburn today, and I see the clips of him. I didn't realise how many spectacular goals that Dave scored. He's absolutely, and his dribbling skills were second to none. He was obviously famous for his little foot over, but a lovely lad off the pitch, trained so hard, most of he trained harder than me. And I think Don Howe always said I was one of the best trainers, but Rocky was fantastic. He trained as he played, just fantastic, 100% every single game. And that's the reason I'm in the Rocket tonight, purely for Dave, because he's a, you know, he's missed. You know, he's a great character, great to have around the dressing room, the training pitch, and you know, what a talent on the pitch.
Rodecastle, superb. Remember, like, first when they first got together that side, they were like playing in a four at Tottenham. When we had four players on them every time, it was like Rodecastle was in biting. A good old biting.
That was one of the things with Rodecastle. He's always, he got the ball and he very rarely turned back and looked back.
He was always going forward.
He was always forward, and there was always that.
And he was looking for the ball.
Looking where to put it.
We've got a good side at the moment.
Well, we're going to come around a little bit of a serious party in here, like, because, you know, one of the reasons apart from being in Rocky is to raise some money for Great Ormond Street Hospital. So we're just going to set up for an auction. We've got some beautiful items donated for your fellow Arsenal fans as well. They've been extremely generous. Bob Wilson shirt from 1971. Signed by the great man himself. It's an Andre Arshavin shirt. 230 going once. Anybody more? 240 over here. 300. It's gone straight to £300. It's a signed Jack Wilshere shirt. We've had an online bid of £400. It looks pretty good. Gilberto shirt in a frame, signed by the great man himself. This is donated by Frank Warren, another famous gooner. They are two ringside seats to This Is It at the O2 Arena on the 21st of May, the frame prints. The gentleman is just down here. Please give him a big round of applause for donating this, because he only got it himself for auction a little while ago. And next one we got is Lee. Lee's donating his services as a DJ anywhere within the M25. He will do weddings, he will do birthdays, he will do parties, he'll even do bar mitzvahs if you know one of that lot from up the road. However, we've also got a reserve bid on this one for £200.
Hello there, I'm Alan Davis. I've got Keith Dover with me here.
Hi, hello.
We do a podcast called The Tuesday Club. We've got a special intro on our podcast this week. It's a commentary from the 1987 Littlewoods Cup semi-final when Rocky scored the winner, which is my personal favourite Rocky moment.
Absolutely, absolutely. I used to work at Ford Motor Company and I couldn't speak for 3 days after that game because I was shouting so much. But I've looked at that game recently and you see Rocastle, his teeth clenched, doing this and come on, we can do it. Just wish some of the current squad had that age.
And there, he had a lot of fire about him. Also, he stuck at him with his left foot, which is very unusual.
Very unusual, because he wasn't really, you know, it wasn't his right foot, you know.
But one of the reasons why the fans loved him, not just because he was a fantastic footballer, was because, as you say, he gave everything for the shirt. We were going away to Wrexham in a cup and we lost 2-1 away and they were in the fourth division at the time. We were champions. I mean, it was shameful, it was terrible.
I know the game, yeah.
They scored and Rocky, I remember looking at him, he looked absolutely shocked and then he ran into the net, picked the ball up and ran back. He seemed to be the only one. And I never forget it, things like that stay with me. And it was only a few months later he got sold, which is a great tragedy.
But what I think is good about the man is, not even knowing him, you knew he was a gentleman. And then when you hear other people talk about him, they all said that, what a gentleman he was. And you could just tell that he was a class person, not only as a player, but as a human being. And I had any actual contact with the man, but
you never hear a bad word about him. The other thing I remember about Rocky was he always used to say that when he was a kid coming from South London, he had to get about 9 buses to get to training. Do you remember hearing that? He used to have to go from, I think it was Forest Hill, and get all these buses to go up there. He was a top man. I did meet him on one occasion, it's one of them ones where I spoke, all I could say was, "You're a legend." That's all I managed to say to him.
When your mouth dries up,
I said, "You're still a legend, the hybrid," to the fans, and absolutely. He said, "Thanks very much."
Well, I mean, the fans still sing his name, and that just shows you what a great person he was. I mean, there's something about some people that exude something special. I think that's what Rocastle had. But not that he was a big Eddie or a flash person. No. Just there's something nice about the man. Something intrinsically good.
Yeah, he was a good guy and he's sorely missed. Yeah. And we're very pleased to be here tonight and be part of a tribute to Rocky. Yeah.
To me, he had everything a footballer needs. He was a team player, great, the little step overs, the skill, and I was just actually watching a little bit of video footage of him, and he had a good finish on him as well. And he was a great, you know what, he was part of a team with a great spirit in it, and a central part of that. And the modern day Arsenal team could certainly do with a David Rocastle, and he's sadly missed, and I love Rocky, and that's it really, I love Rocky.